हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू इंस्पायरिंग माइंड्स। आई एम डॉक्टर आश्रय खन्ना, फाउंडर एंड सीईओ इंस्पायरिंग माइंड्स। डॉक्टर जशनप्रीत सिंह, मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर इंस्पायरिंग माइंड्स। सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट यूएसएमएलई स्टेप वन। वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एवरीथिंग लाइक प्रिपरेशन, हाउ टू स्टडी, व्हाट शुड बी द स्टडी प्लान, एंड दिस सीरीज इज ऑल अबाउट द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट रिसोर्सेज एंड हाई टॉपिक्स। सो दिस वीडियो इज अबाउट द एनाटॉमी, which indeed is an important subject, and from USMLE point of view is also all those topics which you should actually focus on. Today Dr. Jashan will tell you everything about it. So without wasting any time, let's get started.
So as you know that we are like now making a USMLE series, and we have discussed already the most important subject, important subjects, and anatomy is also one of them. And anatomy, let's divide first of all anatomy into three sections. Anatomy we can divide on the basis of histology. After that, general anatomy, and after that, systemic anatomy, and after that, neuro anatomy, and also embryology. And embryology, we can divide further on the basis of general embryology or systemic embryology. So let's start from the first of all embryology part. Without embryology, you cannot write the USMLE exam. Like at least you are going to get 4-5 questions on embryology only, general as well as systemic. In general embryology you are going to get at least one question, like on the fertilization part, on the blastocyst part, on the like hormones, like which hormones are effective, endometrial part, like you can get implantation kab hoti hai, blastocyst kab banta hai, kya kab hota hai, like general embryology basic, zygote and that sperm and ovum thing, okay. And after that, systemic embryology, which is like the most high yield topic for the USMLE. You cannot like miss the arches or like cleft or pouches. You have to study all the germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, and one question which you are going to definitely get in your exam, neural crest cell derivatives. Definitely in India also, in MC exam or NEET PG exam, you will get one question related to neural crest derivatives. It is very like a latest topic and very hot topic among the scientists. So they are discovering more and more derivatives of the neural crest nowadays. So definitely you are going to get one question from the neural crest cell derivatives, okay. And also in systemic, they can ask you the how the kidneys are developed, how the heart is formed, gonads are formed. So each and everything is related to the embryology. If you know the embryology, then you can easily study the like general embryology, systemic embryology, then other part of the like pathology. For example, when we are discussing in the like in the medicine part or in the surgery part, when we discuss like testes are drained in which, so you must you have to know that testes are not made in the scrotum. Testes are made in the abdomen, and then they descend down. Okay, so the lymph node where the testes are drained, they are para-aortic lymph nodes. So one must think about that testes are in the scrotum, so it must drain to the superficial inguinal nodes or the deep inguinal nodes, but there comes the embryology. If you know that they are descending from the abdomen to the scrotum in the like embryological period, 7th, 8th or 9th month, then you must know that they are draining to the para-aortic lymph node. And you know that testes is like homologous to the ovary, and ovary is also draining into the para-aortic nodes. So I would say that without embryology, a medical student is nothing. You have to study embryology, then only you can easily study the pathology, surgery part. So how the heart is formed, the heart tube, how the neural tube is formed, also the neural tube defects are very important for the USMLE. You are definitely going to get one question on the neural tube defects. So when the neural tube is formed, so how it is related to the folic acid, and which enzyme markers are there if you have to diagnose the neural tube defect. What is anencephaly, holoprosencephaly? Also the embryology, you have to study the genes which are related to the embryology. For example, sonic hedgehog genes, that WNT gene, that genes related to the caudal and cranial part of the, how the caudal and cranial part of the body is formed, how we decide that it is the left side and this is the right side, how the like the axis of the body is formed, and how these cells have been removed from the fingers, like apoptosis kaise hui yahan pe. So each and everything related to embryology you have to study. I know it's little bit boring, but when I will tell you the study resources, you will find it very easy, and you will find it like start loving the embryology part. Okay,
like even in your medical school exams, this will help you a lot.
In my school time in Ukraine, I used to like I studied embryology and histology from the Inderbir Singh, IB Singh. I don't know much about the foreign author, but for the embryology you can go for the Lippincott, or you can go for the some other books related to embryology. I don't have much idea, but I studied IB Singh, Inderbir Singh embryology, and Inderbir Singh histology. First of all, let's discuss about the embryology only, that I studied Inderbir Singh embryology. And after that, After Inderbir Singh Embryology, I studied the BRS Embryology. There is special book on the embryology by Broad Review series. Actually, gross anatomy is different, embryology is different, and neuroanatomy is different. So basically, three books are available in BRS: neuroanatomy, gross anatomy, and embryo and histology. So I studied BRS embryology, and with this, I used to watch the Kaplan videos. They are not that much helpful, and for the videos, actually I covered all the videos from the Indian authors. I attended many classes, online classes, for the anatomy, because in anatomy Kaplan didn't discuss much about the when we will discuss about the general anatomy and other anatomy, they didn't discuss much about, they focused on the neuroanatomy part and gross anatomy and a little bit on the embryology. Also they didn't discuss much about the histology. So, good video resource you won't find in the anatomy section. You can go for the Board and Beyond or Becker videos if you find it on the internet. So, Indian authors are very Dr. Ashwini's anatomy is there, Dr. Rajesh Kaushal is there for the embryology. So, I would suggest Dr. Ashwini classes for the anatomy if you want to. After that, the videos, review videos and review book, I came directly to the UWorld and First Aid and DIT. First Aid and DIT covered much about the embryology part, and then come to the directly main, our main resource which we are discussing in all the videos, UWorld. UWorld will cover each and everything. You will come to know Mullerian duct derivative, Wolffian duct derivative, and all the disorder related to that, Rogitansky-Amier syndrome, androgen insensitivity syndrome. You will cover each and everything related to embryology part, the disorder, the physiology, the anatomy, the derivatives, each and everything they will cover. Okay, so after the UWorld, whatever the left part is there, you can cover from the Kaplan QBank, First Aid QBank, and always the other resources are there. But most of the high yield topics I have already told you: derivatives, arch derivative, cleft derivative, palate derivative, and neural tube defects and other defects related to the other system. For example, that kidney defects are there, posterior urethral valve anomaly is there, then Potter's anomaly is there. So okay, for embryology this much is enough. Okay, and now comes to the histology part. Histology is for me it was the least important subject in USMLE. I covered histology basically from the First Aid, DIT and UWorld only.
Okay.
First Aid, DIT and embryology only. Histology from the gastrointestinal system is little bit important. You might get a stomach wall and you need to identify the parietal cell, chief cell, mucus cells, or you might get from the liver, you need to identify where are the bile duct, where are the cells are located in liver, or you can get the reproductive histology and you have to identify the where are the seminiferous tubule, where are the Sertoli cells, where are the Leydig cells. So this kind of question you can get in histology, and which are easily covered by the UWorld, DIT and First Aid book.
Okay.
You will get the images in the UWorld, and you can easily save those images for your later revision. Okay. And now comes to the gross anatomy. Gross anatomy, you can watch the Kaplan videos. Gross anatomy is good there. In gross anatomy, they are basically discussing about the limbs and the splancology. In gross anatomy, the important topics are liver is very important, gastrointestinal anatomy is very important, all that rotation, midgut rotation thing, and the disorder related to that, Meckel's diverticulum, wall valves, all those things are very important. And in the limbs, you need to know the brachial plexus, lumbar plexus, sacral plexus, and disorder related to that. In India, we usually covered those disorder in clinical anatomy or orthopedics, but in USMLE, you will study everything under gross anatomy. All the plexus, brachial plexus is very important. You might get one question related to the clump's fallacy, Off's fallacy, or ape's thumb. We might get question. So gross anatomy you can easily cover from the Kaplan videos, then Kaplan notes, and after that DIT and First Aid, and then UWorld. Same.
Okay.
And now comes the last, neuroanatomy. Neuroanatomy, if you are in the first year medical school, then you cannot afford to watch Dr. Najib videos. You have to study those videos. Dr. Najib really covered the neuroanatomy in his videos. Usually they are very long. It takes around 1 month to cover all the neuroanatomy from Dr. Najib. But if you have time, then you must go for it. Otherwise, if you are your intern or you have already graduated, then you can go for the Kaplan Neuroanatomy by Dr. White. He's the best teacher for me for neuroanatomy. In 16 hours or 20 hours videos, only 4 or 5 lectures of 4 hours each, he really covered all the neuroanatomy. And neuroanatomy is the most important high yield part of the anatomy for the USMLE. You are going to definitely you are going to get 2 or 3 questions related to the spinal cord myelin section. where you need to identify the which track is going from the lateral side, anterior side, and what will be the function if affected. That Brown-Séquard syndrome, which we call it like hemisection of the spinal cord. Cerebellum is very important. You need to know all the cells of the cerebellum and what are the functions. Tracks, which are important tracks are like dorsal track is very important, lateral spinothalamic, anterior spinothalamic, and the motor track, corticospinal is important. Other tracks are less important. Even for India, they don't focus on the like the rubrospinal and pontine spinal, so they don't follow like the much these tracks. Only four tracks are very important: lateral spinothalamic, anterior spinothalamic, dorsal track, and corticospinal.
And along with neuroanatomy, you can read neurophysio as well, right?
Together. Yes, neurophysiology. Actually, everything related to neuro is very important. It might be anatomy, physiology, pathology. So everything related to neuro is very important for the USMLE. But and you will also get the question that there is a like there is a lesion in the pons, there is a lesion in the medulla oblongata, there is a lesion in the like at the level of the sixth cranial nerve, all the cranial nerves, all their nuclei, all the foramina of the skull, whatever the like the structures passing through the foramina, for example, foramen rotundum, wall, foramen spinosum, foramen lacrum, for us like hypoglossal and canal. You have to study neuroanatomy in detail. For a neuroanatomy, Dr. White video with Kaplan notes. And if you don't find Kaplan notes interesting, like for the neuroanatomy, videos are very good, but Kaplan notes are not that much important. And I studied BRS neuroanatomy with the Kaplan videos. And when I was in the, like my first year or second year med school, then I studied the neuroanatomy from the Dr. Najib's video already. So BRS neuroanatomy with Kaplan videos. After that, first aid book and DIT videos for the neuroanatomy. And after that, you would.
Okay.
The whatever left part will be there, you will cover, and also you will get to know many many new mnemonics and techniques how to identify the vertebra. For example, if you are given vertebra and you have to identify that whether it is a lumbar vertebra or thoracic vertebra or it is sacral vertebra, you will get many mnemonics from the UWorld. And also you will get myelin stained section, that how to identify which level of the vertebra it is. And I didn't talk in this video, in this like high yield topic, I didn't focus much on the radiology because I thought I will take radiology in the anatomy section only. So you will get radiological anatomy also.
Okay.
For example, you might get x-ray or MRI or CT scan where you need to identify the anatomical structures.
Okay.
You are like in pathology also a little bit radiology will be there. See, that's Dr. Dashri I was talking about.
Okay.
It's a non-clinical exam, but they are covering radiology also in step one.
Okay.
Like I got one question and where I need to identify the prostate. So You know that prostate is around the urethra.
Yeah.
So you can easily identify on the radiological section. But the thing is, you must have basics, like how the bone look like on the CT scan and how the bones look like on the MRI. What are the T1 weighted images? What are the T2 weighted images in MRI? And CT scan, how to identify that whether there is an epidural hematoma or subdural hematoma. So, I didn't talk earlier, but yes, you will get radiology also, but anatomical only, and little bit pathology. Like for example, epidural and subdural hematoma, we will discuss in the pathology part, how to identify radiologically. And also like subarachnoid hemorrhage, cerebral hemorrhage, intracerebral hemorrhage, you will get like, these are the very common cases, you can say.
Yes.
Hey, this is like a hematoma. So you must know about them. And also radiological anatomy, you will get a section. And maybe sometimes they will ask you, this section or this CT scan is taken from which vertebra level. For example, if you are seeing the liver there, then you must know that the image is above the T1. If you are not seeing the liver and you are seeing the kidney, then you must know that this image is below the T10. It might be around L1, L2 or L3, where the location of kidneys are. So either you need to identify the level or you need to identify the structure. Like for example, if you get a section and they will ask you where is the aorta or where is the esophagus.
Okay.
You know that esophagus is just for later to the aorta. For example, if we put probe like a trans esophageal echography, if we do, you know that the very next forward structure to the esophagus is left atrium and behind it is aorta.
Yes.
So we can do easily trans esophageal echocardiography.
Yes.
So also you can get question on the instrument, like I said, trans esophageal echocardiography. They will tell you, like they will put you that question and they will ask you which structure is behind the esophagus. So you must know that behind the esophagus there will be aorta, and just forward to the esophagus there will be left atrium, which is the most posterior part of the heart. Okay. And also you will get little bit some questions related to ECG. For example, you must know the basic ECG, which you will study in the physiology, and also you will get some pathological ECG. Don't worry, remain what would I say, that don't think that it is a clinical, but you will get little bit ECG part also. For example, in pathology, when you will study the myocardial infection, mm-hmm. then you will study the ST elevation, T wave depression, mm-hmm. T wave like ST depression. Mm-hmm. You will easily get that if there is ischemia, there will be ST depression. If there is like infarction, there will be ST segment elevation. Mm-hmm. And you must know about the coronary circulation. If you know the coronary circulation, then you must know that which type of heart myocardial infarction seen on the which type of lead. If mm-hmm. there is one or 1-2 or AVF lead, mm-hmm. for example, you know that these are the downward leads. So it is inferior wall infection, 1-2 AVF. If there is anterior lead, then you know V2, V3, V4. If lateral, then V4, V5. And you must, you will definitely get one question related to coronary circulation. And most important is lead, like left corner, left anterior descending, then left circumflex, right coronary circulation. So I would suggest, you will get all these questions in the UWorld. You don't need to worry about, you don't need to study any other resource for the radiology, for the ECG. Mm-hmm. You will get all these questions in the UWorld. Okay?
So
I think it's enough, like for the not me.
We have covered almost everything.
Yeah.
So, but still, if you have any doubt, you can always ask us in the comment section.
Yeah, might be something I forget to cover. You can ask in the comment section, okay?
And if you think if we have missed, then you can add it in the comments down below. So that was it for this video. You can just check it again. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Give this video a big thumbs up. And we are aiming for at least 1,000 likes this time, because we have worked really hard for this one. Please share it with all your friends, and after you subscribe to our channel, you just have to write "I have subscribed" and you might be the lucky winner to get a free consultation for USMLE Step 1. So that was it from our side. Thank you and see you soon.